In this video, we're going to be taking a close look at this 32 amp three-phase and neutral industrial socket outlet from Lewden from their Alupress range. Now, this is clearly a cut above the usual socket outlet that you may install, and it's very much designed for tough industrial applications where external influences could cause some serious damage to the electrical equipment. So typical applications for this might include things like steelworks, foundries, blast furnaces, deep freeze industries, and really any areas with the presence of highly abrasive substances. This is reflected in the fact that the socket outlet has an IP rating of 67 and an IK rating of 10, which is the highest achievable impact rating. If you'd like to know a little bit more about what impact ratings and IP ratings are and how they affect your installation work, then please do go and check out our free accredited training package that we've made on this subject, which will count towards your annual CPD requirements. Click the link in the description below or head over to the Lewden Academy tab on lewden.com. So what makes this socket outlet so incredibly tough? Well, for one, the body is made of an aluminium alloy, not GRP or plastic, which makes it really impact resistant. Not only that, the aluminium alloy is passivated using fluorozirconium, which speeds up the natural process that aluminium goes through to build up a protective surface layer on there. This is then reinforced with a powder-coated finish to offer a high level of surface protection. The high IP rating is achieved in a few different ways. The fixings are on the outside of the rear enclosure to prevent holes through the back where moisture could ingress. On the top and bottom, there's access plates with sealing gaskets. One plate is solid, and the other comes with a threaded spout to allow the use of an armoured or stuffing gland. And notice that this spout here has a nice flat face on top to allow a washer to make a good seal on there. The plates at top and bottom are exchangeable to allow you to bring your cable in through different routes. The lid and base are permanently connected to each other by this hinge down on the bottom, so when you undo the screws, it folds open for easy access to the connections. That's a really nice touch that means that the lid isn't flapping in the wind, getting damaged or lost while you're installing it. And the fixing screws here are captive, meaning that they won't fall out and disappear. The high IP rating is maintained by this seal around the outside, which is actually fixed into a groove, meaning that it won't fall out of place or have to be wrestled back into position when you do screw the lid on. Now, looking at the incoming terminals at the top here, you can see that there's a shield in place to help prevent contact with live parts. If you remove that and look at the connections, you'll be able to see there that they're a cage type terminal, making for really easy connections that minimizes damage to the conductors and give a really secure termination. The isolator up here is an AC23 type, which means that it can be used for switching off highly inductive loads, perfect for things like motors, transformers, and welders. There's a couple of other great safety features on the outlet. If we close the lid back up and have a look at the socket outlet, we get another application of IP ratings because the terminals themselves are rated at IP2X, which if you've completed our CPD package on this subject, you'll know means that the terminals cannot be accessed by solids greater than 12.5 millimeters in diameter, or fingers, as we call them. The outlet goes one step further in this regard. You can see that when I try to operate the isolating switch at the top, it simply won't turn on. This is because the socket is interlocked, which means that it can't be energized without a plug being inserted, which is a requirement in BS7671 for certain types of installation. So when we insert a plug into the outlet, you can see, if we just do that, that it then allows for the operation of the isolation switch. So there you go. And you'll notice that once it's energized, I can't then remove the plug so that it can't be left energized without the plug being connected. Now, if we switch the isolator off and remove the plug, we can open up the enclosure and see how this works. If I try and manually operate the isolator switch, you can see this long connected bar down here is trying to push downwards, but it can't because of the molded aluminium section here. Looking at the socket element, there's this plunger with a spring attached to it, and when the plug connects, it pushes it down and activates this lever, which lifts up the bottom section of the sliding bar and then allows the whole bar to slide down when the isolator is operated. You'll also see that when the plug goes in and the isolator switched, it brings up this retaining hook, which latches over the keyway on the plug and prevents the plug from being removed when the socket is energized. Another interesting requirement of IEC 60309, which relates to this kind of socket outlet, is that the electrical contacts in the socket barrel are located at different depths to ensure that when inserting a plug, the earth is connected first, and then the neutral, and then the phases. When withdrawing the plug, this is of course the opposite. So the phases disconnect first, then the neutral, then the earth. This sequence prevents loss of neutral in three-phase systems, which may be connected to single-phase loads further down the line. So there we go. This is one seriously robust industrial socket outlet that Lewden have produced, and there's a whole variety of different options available in different voltages and current ratings, as well as built-in protective devices like MCBs and RCDs, so you know there's a socket for every situation. Again, if you want to know much more about IP and IK ratings, then please do go and check out our free accredited training package for your ongoing CPD and for your own learning as well. But as always, we want to hear from you. Do you install industrial socket outlets? Have you ever worked in an environment where additional levels of IP and IK ratings were required? Which feature of the outlet do you like the most? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.